because you say I'm a problem doesn't mean I can't be somebody else's answer. So I can't let how you see me determine my value. Just because you see me as a problem doesn't mean I can't be an answer. Stop crying over what you lost. God let you lose it because it is less than what he's about to give you. Joseph's mama saw him as an answer. Joseph's brothers saw him as a problem. Whenever he was seen as a problem, he went down. They put him in the pit because they saw him as a problem. The people who rejected you, they rejected you because they see you as a problem. You're walking around in that fancy coat, all in many colors. See, whenever you are getting blessed, there are always somebody who sees your blessing as a problem. You heard me tell you this before. I've never had a hater that was doing better than me. Trying to kill me. No, it's always somebody up under me throwing rocks up, trying to destroy me, because they see my blessing as their problem. Oh, I'm gonna talk to you today. Look back over your life. All of your haters are always somewhere up under you trying to knock you out of your position. Because they have a problem with your blessing. They have a problem with your coat of many colors. They have a problem with the anointing that's on your life. They have a problem with the gifts that are in your spirit. They have a problem with the blessing that's on your family. They have a problem with the blessing that's in your house. They have a problem because you got a new car. They got a problem because you bought a house. They got a problem because your kids went to school. They always have a problem with your blessing. And the people who will throw you in a pit will throw you in a pit because they see you as a problem. The Midianites came along, looked down in the pit, and they saw him as an answer. When the Midianites looked down in the pit, they saw an answer, so they pulled him out. Because they saw an answer, they said, we can make money off him. We can do something with him. We can use him. The boys put you in because they see you as a problem. The Midianites pull you out because they see you as an answer. They sold him to Potiphar as an answer. If you give something for him, he will be an answer. Potiphar gave money because he saw him as an answer. You've been praying for money. You don't have to pray for money anymore. All you got to do is say, Lord, make me an answer. See, you're not serious about it. That's why it's not going to work for you. You're not serious about it. You would rather pray for money. You don't have to pray for money. If you become an answer, people will start throwing money at you because you are the... That's why you got the interview, is to show the boss that you're an answer. If you show me you're an answer, I will pay to have you. Because as I told you a few weeks ago, sacrifice always determines value. You think you have a problem, but what you have is an opportunity to show you are an answer. This is prosperity for somebody. Something's about to happen in your life. Things are getting ready to shift in a radical way. Potiphar sees Joseph as an answer. And now Joseph is running house without paying for the house he's running. That's favor. When God drops you into a situation and you get to lay in that bed and live in that house and enjoy that blessing that you didn't have to work for, I don't know whether your faith is ready for this, but God will give you houses that you didn't build, vineyards that you didn't even grow. He'll give you opportunities that don't match your background, your education, your pedigree. It's not on your resume, but when God opens up a door, he's going to set you into a supernatural blessing. If you have the faith to receive it, give me 30 seconds of... The blessing is going to come looking for you. In fact, stop looking for the blessing and find the problem. Click. It's going to open up. When I hear a click, I will no longer despise all the dents in me. Because I'll understand it's the dents in me that made me fit the situation. So I'll start saying it was good for me that I was afflicted. Because if I wasn't afflicted like this, I couldn't open up this opportunity like this. Slap your neighbor and tell him you're about to open up something. Click into your next dimension. As long as Potiphar saw Joseph as an answer, he got to stay in the house until his wife fell in love with him, and that became a problem. And when Potiphar looked at him and saw him as a problem and not an answer, he goes back down. So somebody's problem is somebody's answer. That means that just because you say, I'm a problem, doesn't mean I can't be somebody else's answer. So I can't let how you see me determine my value. Just because you see me as a problem doesn't mean I can't be an answer. Oh, wait. Is anybody getting this? Is anybody getting this? I came in here the other day. I brought my grandkids in because they were visiting. My family was here, and they had a bunch of friends with them. I took them on the tour, showed them the new building, and then we came right here, and all of them wanted to take a picture. The problem was all the lights weren't on in the sanctuary. So Sean had turned on some lights, but it wasn't enough lights to get a good picture. Now, my grandbaby, Kenzie, how old is Kenzie? Six. Kenzie's 6 years old. All the little kids are on these steps right here about to take a picture. And we're getting ready to take the picture, but the picture's going to be dark. I said, the picture's going to be dark because we don't have all the lights on. Kenzie jumped up and ran down there and found a flashlight. So she ran up here with the flashlight and stood here holding the flashlight so we could take the picture. So somebody said to her, Kenzie, don't you want to get in the picture? She said, no, I don't want to be in the picture. I want to hold the light. She understood that she didn't have to be in the picture. If she was holding the light, it was more important to hold the light than to be in the picture. You've been trying to be in the picture, but God called you. Joseph would have died in jail. The famine created a need that Pharaoh couldn't supply, but gave Joseph an opportunity for his gift to operate. Because God knew that the gifts will make room for a man and bring him before a great man. See, but the problem with you don't appreciate your own gift. You got to understand that what God gave you, I don't care what your brother said. God's going to put you in a situation where somebody sees you as an answer, and don't you argue with them. God's going to put you in a situation where God sees you as an answer, and don't talk them out of it. God's going to put you in a situation where they see you as an answer, and don't let your insecurity say, suppose I can't interpret the dream. I don't know if that'll work like that. I never tried to do that in the palace. I've never been in a palace in my life. I don't have nothing to wear. They told Joseph, they said, Pharaoh wants you. Joseph doesn't doubt. He doesn't argue. He doesn't draw back. He doesn't seem intimidated. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Why does Joseph not feel intimidated? Joseph has never been in a palace in his life. He has no training for it. He has no background for it. But Joseph is cut in all the right places. Joseph now recognizes from the time he was a kid wearing that coat, it was preparing him for the role. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. He says, when I was running Potiphar's house, it was training to run the nation. Joseph now understands what I'm going to tell you. Everything that he lost, he was supposed to lose. Because everything he lost was preparing him for this. And had he been successful and stayed in Potiphar's house, he would have settled for something that was less. This is God's word to somebody. Stop crying over what you lost. God let you lose it because it is less than what he's about to give you. Somebody holler, Lord, make me an answer. Algebra. We go from addition to algebra. Addition shows you the problem. It's a problem looking for an answer. Algebra is an answer looking for a problem. The reason you have been successful is that you think you are a problem looking for an answer, but you are really an answer. Who's with me tonight? everything you practiced on was beneath you. Everything you practiced on was beneath you. It wasn't your real destiny. Everything you practiced on was preparation for what he is about to release in your life. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but whoever it is, give him a praise right now. You're getting ready. Touch your neighbor and say, get ready, get ready, get ready. Listen, you don't have long to get ready. The Bible said that Joseph shaved himself, changed his garments, and went before Pharaoh. He shaved himself, changed his garments, and went before Pharaoh. He shaved himself, changed his garments, and went before Pharaoh. You gotta get ready for what God is about to do in your life. So I'm going to cut off everything that looks like where I came from. He shaved himself. We got shaved fast. Everything you went through that's hanging on to you, that's worrying your mind, that's holding you down, shave it off right now.
You're going to lose the palace
find yourself in a prison. God is going to set you into a situation that feels too big for you. Because he has made you an answer. Now listen to this. You see how broken you are. Said, give me that key back. You see how broken you are, and all your mistakes and all your crazy ways of what happened to you and what you went through and how you feel and what you think. But God was shaping you. Tried this key before. Have you ever stuck a key in a lock and it went in but it wouldn't turn? Every blessing you had, you went in and never turned because it was practice. This is the season for you to come into the place that you will never forfeit, but you have to see your uniqueness as an answer and not a problem. Because if you keep seeing it as a problem, you will keep staying in the prison. You gotta say, oh God, I thank you that I went through everything I went through because it prepared me. You're about to do in my life. Joseph was a Hebrew running Egypt. He went from being a slave to being a master. This is the season, and over the next few weeks, I'm going to be talking about this. Some people tell you you can't have it all. That's a lie. This is the season that the little areas in your life that have been out of place, God's going to bring them into place. If you align yourself with this word and let this word be in you. Joseph never went into another prison. He never went down. He never went in another pit. He never went broke. He never was in burden with troubles. He had a position of prominence and power. I'm not saying that he didn't have struggles and tests and trials, but he never went back. He never went back. I had to preach this to you tonight. I don't hear anybody telling you about the place where you never go back to where you came from again. Now, some of you haven't been through anything that you never want to go through again. But some of us have gone through some things that we don't ever join hands with somebody. Could it be possible? Can you believe it? That the prisoner is now the prince. And now he's giving orders and not taking them. He is now controlling the wealth of Egypt.